we said databases, we need to talk about securing access to them because there's something different about databases. Well, there's structure in the data and how we access it. And we talked about access control, which is sort of something that we had discussed before. So are there sort of unique kind of attacks that are possible on databases? So that's what we want to explore next. What kind of threats are possible because either the structure of the data that we have in the database or the way we access it through the query languages like SQL, for example. So we're going to talk about a couple of different possible attacks. The first one we're talking about is what is called injection, SQL injection, or we'll see that these are essentially someone exploiting vulnerabilities in the code that makes up the query that is submitted to a database. Query is written SQL, then it's an SQL query, and the attack is called SQL injection. So what really is an SQL injection is a malicious command, okay? This is a command that is presented to the database. So the database is going to actually run it. Malicious because it's going to allow someone to do something that they're not authorized to do. The results, of course, are not going to be consistent with the kind of security that you're looking to provide for this database. These kind of attacks, injection attacks, when successful, they can disclose large amounts of data. We talked about disclosures of customer data and so on earlier. So if you do that, of course, you're impacting confidentiality of the database. You're extracting data from the database that is being made public or going to somebody who shouldn't have access to it. These injection attacks can also corrupt or delete the data that's there, some sort of tuples in a table or something like that. That could impact integrity of the data. So injection attacks can corrupt, which is integrity, or disclose, which is confidentiality. And both of these bad outcomes are possible when these kind of attacks, we can discuss what they are successful. For us to understand what these SQL injection attacks are, we have to sort of learn something else, which is a lot of times the databases are sort of in the back end of the system. The front end is some sort of web application environment that you have, okay? And the user interacts with the web application and presents, we're going to do an example in a minute, some sort of request to the application. Well, that application then translates to a query that goes out to the database. And that query is typically generated by a script based on the user input. So user wants something done, provides input for it. There's a script that takes that input, generates a query, and then submits that SQL query, for example, to the database. So this is the kind of environment that we're talking about. And what happens is that there is a vulnerability in the web application itself. Okay, this is web application is coded, it's software. So there's a software vulnerability, and SQL injection attacks basically exploit that vulnerability to craft these injection attacks that we're talking about. Okay, so just to make this idea of SQL injections concrete and the script and the web application and so on, let's do an example. Okay, so the example is the database that stores data about, you know, what is shipped where and things like that. It's a collection of the orders, for example, a company may have received. Okay, orders that whenever an order is placed, we create a tuple. Of course, one piece of information, the attribute in that tuple is going to say where the item is going to be shipped. And this is, let's say, specified by the user. So user says, you know, I'm purchasing something and, you know, I want it sent to this city. The way the web application supports user interaction is maybe using a form, and you fill the form with this needed information, including the city that we're talking about. So the user interacts with the form, fills in the various fields, including the city that we have here. And then we said this web application now has to generate a query. So the script code that generates the query is included the sort of the example here. So the code is going to be a SQL query that we have to generate. So the script basically is saying from the form, you read the user input, which is the city where we're going to ship a certain item. So this statement ship city is basically saying, you know, from the form, you read this value. And, you know, that's if you want to send it to New York, for example, that's what we're going to have here. Once we have that, we're saying generate the SQL query. okay, in quotes. So the query is going to say select everything from orders table where the attribute ship city is what this input is provided to us. Okay, so we're going to add that. We'll see that the resulting query is actually going to be select star from orders table where ship city is, you know, if you put New York City here, it'll be ship city equals New York. Okay, so that's an example. I think the only thing that's important here is that the user, the injection attack, the way it's going to work is that somebody is going to provide bad input. So we talked about buffer overflows through bad input before. It's not quite the same, but it's kind of like that. And so injection is going to occur because of bad input. So the idea here is that you're getting the input here from the user. Based on that, you're generating a query. And this query is what's going to be submitted to the database.